The impact of the COVID-19 pandemic on Greek businesses and the European Union's reaction to the economic impact. Ioanna Dimitrakaki, Management and Marketing Department, Faculty of Economics, International Hellenic University of Greece. Aim of the research. The aim of this research is to capture the effects of the pandemic crisis in the economy and society of Greece and the European Union, as well as the opinions which have been formed both for the basic political choices and for the changes which are caused by the pandemic, which seems to function like a digital accelerator. COVID-19 history. The coronavirus disease 2019 COVID-19, also known as acute respiratory disease 2019 COV, is a communicable disease which is caused by the SARS-CoV-2 coronavirus. The virus and the disease were first found in the Chinese city Wuhan in the late 2019 and became known to the World Health Organization on 31 December 2019. Since then, it has been disseminated in the whole planet and it has been developed in a pandemic. The name COVID-19 was given by the World Health Organization and it is an acronym of the letters CO, standing for Corona, which means Crohn, V standing for Virus D, standing for disease, and it is standing for the year of its first being recorded. The evolution of COVID-19 disease. COVID-19 is a disease which is caused by a new type of coronavirus, SARS-CoV-2. It was first located in China on December 2019. On December 2019, a COVID-19 outbreak was recorded in the Chinese city of Wuhan and it was quietly transmitted to other regions of China and of the world. On January 2020, isolated cases appeared in certain European Union state members. On late February 2020, Italy reported a significant decrease of COVID-19 cases, mainly in the northern regions of the country. Most of the rest of the European Union state members began reporting cases of infection. On March 2020, every European Union state member started reporting COVID-19 cases. The number of cases has been increasing since then. The European Union's Council, along with the rest of the institutional organization of the European Union, has been keeping a close eye on the situation and it has been taking measures. Those include the publication of relevant states by the European Union and the continuous coordination with state members regarding the exchange of information, the appraisal of needs and the assurance of a uniform reaction in the European Union's level. The impact of the disease on Greek enterprises. The pandemic afflicted the Greek economy as well as the other economies of the Eurozone with extremity from the last first quarter of 2020. The pressure peaked in the second quarter of 2020 as it was proved from the data regarding the historic depression of this quarter, minus 15.2% decrease of the GDP in a yearly basis. COVID-19 has caused extremely unpleasant conditions in which the interest parts of businesses search for other sources of information or for resources in order to regain their credibility. In conclusion, in this hard period when the economy suffers from COVID-19, there is a hope for businesses to recover provided that they handle the emergency properly and capitalize on opportunities which may appear in the future. The effect of the disease on Greek economy. Tackling the COVID-19 pandemic crisis with extensive restraint and personal protection measures adopted has changed economic and social activities. The effects of the health crisis on the economic are manifested in the form of deep recession negatively affecting the financial situation of companies, employment and fiscal figures. In addition, extensive restrictions and distancing measures have affected the social and consumer behavior of citizens. measure of restriction of the virus taken by the Greek authorities. The Greek sanitary and state authorities have edited the following measures in a chronological order, some of them in a state level and others a local level. On 10 March, it was decided to close every educational institution due to the virus and repression in a large part of the country. On 30 March, the suspension of the function of stores of sanitary eateries was announced. On about mid-March, the frontiers of the country with Albania, North Macedonia and Turkey closed. On 16 March, the total suspension of every religious ceremony, of every dogma and religion was decided. On 17 March, Greece and the other state members of the European Union decided to close the external frontiers of the European Union. On 19 March, the Ministry of Tourism announced the suspension of the function of every hotel. In late March, Greece suspended every passenger flight from the United Kingdom and the Hellenic Civil Aviation Authority decided the suspension of every flight to and from Italy, Spain, Turkey, the United Kingdom, the Netherlands, and Germany. From 4 March, the plan of the government from the restart for the businesses function became effective. Suspension of businesses function. According to the data of the Hellenic Statistical Authority, the businesses in the total of the Greek economy which suspended their function on March 2020 on a state coma due to the pandemic of COVID-19 disease are 205,000.984. They account for 14.6% of the 1,415,370 of the businesses of the Greek economy, and they belong to 50 fields. In those 50 fields, the total number of businesses is 398,115, and we conclude from this that they account for 28.1% of the businesses of the economy, and that the businesses that suspended their function account for over the half of them, 51.70%. Employees in the businesses that suspended their function in March 2020. In the 205,984 businesses of the 50 fields which suspended their function, the total of economy, 1,063,980 individuals are employed, a percentage of 25.4%. percent out of 4,178,119 employees. In those 15 fields, the total number of the employees is 1,068,208, and we conclude from this that they account for 37.5% of the Greek economy employees, and that the employees whose contracts were suspended account for over 2-3 of them, 67.8%. Fields that suffered from COVID-19. Wholesale, 65%. Processing, 17%. Retail, 54%. Energy, 37%. Transport and storage, 7%. Accommodation and food services, 7%. Information and communication, 47%. Other fields, 85%, total of suffering fields, 69%. 69% of the whole turnover is produced by businesses which have been suffering from COVID-19. 58% is produced by businesses which are included in the business activity codes regarding the support measures without being forced to interrupt their activity. 11% is produced by businesses which were forced to suspend their function. Prospects of recovery development on the Greek economy during 2021 to 2023. The recovery of the international and the Greek economy since 2021 is based on the assumption that the COVID-19 transmission has actually begun to abate since May 2021, mainly due to the gradual vaccination, and that the pandemic will continue to exist until late 2021. the increase of tourism compared with 2020, and Greece's favorable image abroad allows it to assert an increased market share. Apart from that, since a fair recovery is also expanded 2021 in the index from international transport, which was severely decreased in 2020, approximately minus 18.32%. Thus, an increase of the exports in 10% is expected in 2021 after the large decrease of minus 20.1% in 2020. Regarding the imports, the restricted decrease in 2020, minus 6.6%, entail an evaluation for the recovery in 5.2% in 2021 in view of the exports increased 10% and the evaluation of increasing the final domestic expenditure in the economy in 3.4%. Therefore, an increase of the GDP is expected 2021, 4.5% first quarter, minus 0.5%, second quarter 7%, third quarter 6.3%, and fourth quarter 5.1%. The development path of the country is expected to continue in 2022 with a GDP increase 4.2% nominal GDP, 5.2% in 2023 with a GDP increase of 3.2% nominal GDP, 4.3%. When the COVID-19 pandemic broke out in early March 2020, the government immediately applied a set of import interventions of approximately €23, 89 billion on agreed finance costs, aiming at the interruption of the virus transmission and the financial support of the economy fields, which suffered from important turnover and profits losses due to the lockdown, which was imposed for the restriction of the virus transmission. More especially, the government has applied 62 categories of measures against COVID-19, which are classified the following categories. 22 of the intervention result in a decrease of the general government earnings on financial cost of €4.92 billion in 2020 and €1.78 billion in 2021. 34 of the intervention result in increase of the GHG expenditure on a financial cost of €10.73 billion in 2020 and €5.54 billion in 2021. 4 of the intervention in financial neutral, supporting the economy sectors which have suffered unprecedented financial repercussions due to the pandemic, is the target of those interventions. Conclusions regarding the public finance of the country after COVID-19. The impact of COVID-19 on Greece's financial prospects is great. The financial burden from COVID-19 was €21.3 billion in 2020 and it will continue in 2021 with a loss of minus €12.8 billion and 2022 with a loss of minus €8 billion. Despite this, Greece can rejoin development, as that is what is needed to keep the country's international competitiveness in a high level and to stably develop the Greek economy, according to its powerful comparative advantages. The direct response of the European Union to COVID-19 outbreak. Since the outbreak of COVID-19 disease took place, the European Union has been collaborating with its state members for the protection of health and prosperity of the European Union citizens and for the rescue of human lives. The response of the European Union to COVID-19 pandemic focuses on four priorities: restriction of the virus transmission, security of medical equipment supply, promotion of research for treatments and vaccines, support of employment, business and economy. The Europe Council has been regularly recurring in the COVID-19 issue. The European Union's leaders agreed to continue the coordination attempts in the European Union level, focusing on the following: strategies for the conduction of tests and use of antigen rapid tests, reciprocal accreditation of diagnostics, cross-border contact tracing, quarantine arrangements, development, production and disposal of vaccines against COVID-19, interfactional digital vaccination certificates. Plan for the recovery of Europe. The leaders of the European Union agreed to draw up a plan of recovery for Europe in order to support European Union citizens, businesses and states during the recovery from the financial misery caused by the COVID-19 pandemic. On 23 April 2020, they committed to organize a feud for the recovery of the European Union in order to abate the repercussions of the crisis. On 21 July 2020, the European Union's leaders agreed in a total budget of 184.4 billion euros for the period 2021 to 2027. These data have been added to the three safety nets of 540 billion euros, which have been already applied by the European Union for the support of employees, businesses and countries. The Europe Council and the European Parliament came to a political agreement of the set of measures in 10 November 2020. In the European Council meeting, which took place in December 10-11-2020, the uses which have resulted from the agreement were dealt with and the appropriation of the set of recovery measures was set before 1 January 2021. In 11 February 2021, the Europe Council edited the regulation for the establishment of a recovery and resilience faculty. This means, which is a center of next generation European unions, provide a support of 672.5 billion euros to state members in order to help the confront the economic and social consequences of the COVID-19 pandemic. On 30 July 2021, the top 12 European Union countries, Austria, Belgium, France, Germany, Denmark, Greece, Spain, Italy, Lithuania, Luxembourg, Portugal and Slovakia took the green use European Union funds for recovery and resilience to stimulate their economies and recover from the effects of COVID-19. On 28 July 2021, four more European Union countries received the green light: Croatia, Cyprus, Lithuania and Slovenia. Businesses. The European Investment Bank Group has set up a pan-European 25 billion euros quarantine fund. The fund provides loans totaling up 200 billion to businesses with an emphasis on small and medium-sized enterprises across the European Union. On 9 April 2021, the Council approved an additional 121.5 million euros through the Solidarity and Emergency Assistance Reserve to address the COVID-19 pandemic emergency. The European Union and its member states have written a great page in their history in recent months thanks to the group action they have taken to help citizens in the face of the COVID-19 pandemic. From providing safe and effective vaccines to sending medical equipment where the needs are greatest and threatening patients from other countries, but also from protecting jobs and workers to providing assistance to partner coastline. The coronavirus. Coronavirus caused the global economy to shrink most after the Great Recession, but positive news about the vaccine led to gradual restoration of confidence. The course of the COVID-19 pandemic, together with conscient measures to curb the spread of the virus and support policies to mitigate the economic impact of the pandemic, have been key determinants of the global growth trend. Let us hope that we will manage to overcome this difficult situation and will be together safe and sound when all this ends. Thank you for your attention.